Imagine you're in a freezing, cold, vast, and empty space where everything around you seems to be white. Bleak and cold conditions, how could anything possibly survive?
Ariel, listen to me. The human world is a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
Even though it seems impossible, there are actually quite a few animals that inhabit the Antarctic landscape, ranging from phytoplankton to the orca whale.
The Antarctic is a place full of hidden wonders.
For the world to be balanced out, the animal kingdom is an essential part of the environment.
Under the sea, darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me.
You may think as the Antarctic is a cold place, there are no planets, but you're mistaken. There aren't very many, but there are a few, of which include the phytoplankton.
Phytoplankton is a photosynthesizing microscopic organism that inhabits the upper sunlit layer of almost all oceans and bodies of fresh water. It obtains the energy from photosynthesis as well.
As phytoplankton is an aquatic plant, it doesn't have soil as a source of minerals. Therefore, it has evolved to draw minerals such as silic acid from the ocean, and it is crucially dependent on these minerals. So overall, phytoplankton is a very important plant in the Antarctic and every aquatic food web, as it is the base. And in case you already didn't know, if any of you recognize this little guy, he's plankton too.
Moving on to a larger specimen of the ocean, there is the krill. The krill has evolved very effectively according to its environment, as it has three segments to its body: the head, also known as the cephalon, thorax, and its abdomen, helping it to move quicker. It has two pairs of legs for swimming, and several pairs for grooming, feeding. It also illuminates in water.
Normally, krill grow up to 1 to 5 centimetres on the average, and some specimens do grow up to 15 centimetres. Their prey is phytoplankton and occasionally some zooplankton.
Krill normally travel in swarms as to confuse predators who normally feed on single roaming specimens. Their lifespan is 2 to 6 years on the average. They are primary consumers.
Moving further up the food chain, we come to the penguins.
The emperor penguins. They are native to the Antarctic and have evolved to its environment by having densely packed feathers. And although this bird is a land animal, it can dive under the sea over 550 meters deep for up to 20 minutes. Their diet is mainly fish, like krill and squid, and are secondary consumers, but are hunted by the orca and the leopard seal.
The leopard seal is most common in the southern hemisphere, mostly in the Antarctic, but can also be found in places like Australia, South Africa, New Zealand, and the Atlantic coast of South America.
The leopard seal feeds on krill, squid, and other fish, as well as the emperor penguin. Its lifespan is 26 years on the average.
At the top of the Antarctic food chain, we have the orcas, or the killer whales.
Orcas are toothed whales belonging to the oceanic dolphin family. They are found in both the Arctic and the Antarctic.
They are known for preying on penguins, seals, and smaller whales. Both the leopard seal and the orca are tertiary consumers.